Bayou Blessings. Aye. A silly word and a scripture word from Ed Shirley, seasoned with Cajun humor, I guarantee. Right here be the Cajun joke. My conscience, it bothered me so bad I not sleep at night. I took myself to the church for confession. It been a long time since this Cajun had a confession. I say, Father Roboget, forgive me for I have sinned. He say, what you done did, Boudreau? Father, there be this new construction site by my house. I snuck it out there at night and took some lumber. Father Roboget ask, well, what you did with that lumber, Boudreau? I say, well, there be a board missing on my porch. I afraid somebody come to see me and steps in that hole and broke it their leg. So I replaced some boards on my porch. Father Roboget say, well, that not bad. And I say, well, Father Roboget, I had some more lumber left over after that. He say, well, what you done did with that lumber, Boudreau? Well, my dog Fido be out there when it runs and be cold and no place to go, so I builded him a dog house. Father Roboget said, well, that's still not bad. And I say, well, Father Roboget, I had some more lumber left over after that. He said, well, what you done did with that lumber, Boudreau? And I say, my wife, she complains that there's not enough room around the house, and I built 2 bedrooms, a bath, and a 2-car garage. Father Roboget said, now that ridiculous. You're going to have to make a penance. Then he asked me, do you know how to make a penance, Boudreau? I answer, no, Father, but if you got the plans, I got the lumber, I guarantee. Right here be the land yap from the Lord.
Psalm 51 verses 7 and 10 record David's words of repentance before the Lord. Cleanse me with hyssop and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be whiter than snow. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Hyssop is a fragrant herb. In the Hebrew culture, a thorough washing of a person in their clothes represented a new start in life. Boudreau started out with just a little bit of sin, replacing a few boards on his porch. Then he digressed to a sinful major building project with a lot of stolen lumber, 2 bedrooms, a bath, and a 2-car garage. Sin is slippery and sneaky. Flirting with a little sin can easily lead to living in sin without a moral conscience. A friend and I walked into a restaurant during the middle of a sunny summer day. There were no windows and the lights were set very low. After groping to find a seat, I complained about being unable to read the menu. My friend said, "Wait a few minutes and your eyes will adjust." He was right. Just spending time in darkness allowed my eyes to function to the point that I could read the menu and maneuver. All of us are in danger of a deadly acclimation to sin's darkness. King David drifted down the same path of spiritual darkness. It was okay to harbor impure thoughts about another person, and then it was fine to plot the murder of an individual for self-gain. Sin doesn't have to be one horrendous act or a surreal defining moment. It can be a gradual falling away from living the right life and a steady separation from the Lord. Like David, we can find forgiveness for sin. We can be cleansed through repentance before Jesus Christ. Bring your soul into Christ's light today and have Him wash away your transgressions and guilt. Start a new life again with Jesus.
Remember to be a happy Cajun. Keep the crawfish in your tummy and Christ in your heart. We pray this by your blessing made you feel more better.